Take a look at this animation. In this animation, a glass prism has been considered, and we are seeing what is happening to a ray of light that is incident on one of the surfaces of the glass prism. So here we consider ray KL that is incident on surface AB of the glass prism. Now, since the light ray is traveling from a rarer medium to a denser medium, it undergoes refraction and it bends towards the normal. Now, after it has undergone refraction, the refracted ray keeps traveling forward inside the glass prism and encounters the second refracting surface, AC. Now, at this surface, there is a glass-air interface. So the light ray is traveling from a denser medium to a rarer medium. So what happens in this case? Refraction takes place and the light ray bends away from the normal, or it shifts away from the normal. Now let us analyze this ray diagram in greater detail. So over here, we consider that a light ray KL is incident on surface AB at point L. So the angle of incidence that KL makes with the normal N1 is I1. I1 is the angle of incidence for the ray of light on surface AB. As you can see from the diagram, angle A is the angle of the prism. That is the angle in between refracting surfaces AB and AC. So once this ray is incident on the refracting surface, it undergoes refraction and it bends towards the normal N1. So after it has bent towards the normal, it is making an angle R1 with the normal. As you can see, since it is traveling from a rarer medium to a denser medium, the light ray has bent or shifted closer to the normal, and it is forming an angle R1 with the normal. Now this light ray moves forward in the glass medium and is incident on the second refracting surface AC. Now if you observe closely, you will find that at point M, where this ray is incident, it is forming an angle of incidence R2 with the normal. If you observe closely, you will find that R1 is the angle of refraction at the first surface and R2 is the angle of incidence at the second surface. So the angle that is the refracted ray is forming with the normal at AC, that is the second surface, is R2. Now since the light ray is traveling from a denser medium to a rarer medium, it undergoes refraction again. So now it bends away from the normal. So when light ray MN bends away from the normal, it is forming an angle I2 with the normal. Angle I2 is the angle of refraction at the second surface of the prism, that is at surface AC. So now we have four angles, angle I1 and R1, that are the angle of incidence and the angle of refraction at the first surface of the prism. And we have angle R2 and angle I2, that are the angle of incidence and angle of refraction at the second surface of the prism respectively. So now let us see what is happening. If you observe closely, you will find that the incident ray was incident along path KLQ. In other words, if the glass prism had not been there, this incident ray would have followed this path. That is path KLQ. Also, if you observe closely, the refracted ray or the emergent ray MN is appearing to come from path PMN. Or in other words, it seems that ray MN is coming from the point P. So what can we say? We can say that this light ray has undergone a change in path or a deviation in the path. What should have gone in this way is going this way. So there is a deviation in the path. This angle is known as the angle of deviation. And this angle of deviation is represented by the letter delta. Also, if you observe closely, the angle that the two normals at the points of incidence are making is given by angle alpha. Angle alpha gives us the angle that the two normals are making inside the glass prism. Now we have to find out what delta or the angle of deviation is if we are given the angle of incidence and the angle of prism. So let us see how we can find that out. So this is the diagram that we obtained when the light ray was falling on the first refracting surface and emerging from the second refracting surface. Now if you observe this diagram closely, what can we say? We can say that angle QPM, that is nothing but delta, is equal to angle PLM, that is this angle, and angle PML, that is this angle. QPM is equal to angle PLM and PML. Why? Because from mathematics we know that in a triangle, the external angle, that is delta, is equal to the sum of two opposite internal angles. So PLM and PML are two opposite and internal angles. They are internal to the triangle and they are opposite to one another. And their sum is equal to the external angle, that is delta. So we can write delta is equal to angle PLM plus angle PML. Now take a look at this. Ray KL is forming an angle I1 with the normal. Now when we have extrapolated ray KL and we have produced the normal inside the glass prism, we can say that angle N1 LK, that is I1, is equal to angle PLO, that is this angle. Why? Because they are vertically opposite. Similarly, if we have extrapolated ray MN and if we produce the normal N2 inside the glass prism, we can say that angle N2 MN, that is I2, is equal to angle PMO, that is this angle. Why? Again, because they are vertically opposite angles, and vertically opposite angles are equal. So we can say that angle PLO, that is this angle, is equal to angle I1, and angle PMO, that is this angle, is equal to angle I2, because in each case they are vertically opposite angles. So now we are writing delta in terms of I1, R1, R2 and I2. Now this entire angle is I1 and this angle is R1. So what can we write this angle as? Angle PLM. We can write angle PLM as I1 minus R1. And since this angle is R2 and this entire angle is I2, we can write angle PML, that is this angle, as I2 minus R2. Now we have already seen that PLM plus PML is equal to delta. Thus, I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2, these two angles are equal to delta. So rearranging this equation, we get I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2 is equal to delta. Now we consider a quadrilateral. The quadrilateral we consider is A, M, O, L. So if we consider quadrilateral A, M, O, L, what are the observations we can make? We can say that angle A, L, O is 90 degrees and also angle A, M, O is 90 degrees. Why? Because normals N1 and N2 are perpendicular to the two refracting surfaces at points L and point M. So we can say that since N1 is a normal, it will be perpendicular, and this angle is 90 degrees along with this angle. So since this is a straight line, this angle will also be 90 degrees and this will also be 90 degrees. So angle ALO and AMO are 90 degrees. Now from mathematics, we know that the sum of interior angles in a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. So the sum of these two angles will be 180 degrees. So if the sum of these two angles is 180 degrees, the sum of this angle and this angle will also be 180 degrees, because 360 minus 180 is 180. Thus, we can say that angle LAM, that is the angle of the prism, angle A, and angle LOM, that is angle alpha, these two angles, when they are summed, gives us 180 degrees. So we are writing angle LOM, that is this angle, as 180 minus this angle, that is nothing but the angle of the prism. That is, angle LAM is nothing but angle A. So now we can say that angle LOM plus R1 plus R2 is equal to 180 degrees. Why are we saying this? We are saying this because this triangle is considered, that is angle LMO. Triangle LMO has been considered. Now we know from mathematics that in a triangle, the sum of interior angles is 180 degrees. So angle LOM plus angle OML plus angle MLO will give us 180 degrees. Thus, LOM plus R1 plus R2 gives us 180 degrees. Now we see that we are getting two relations with angle LOM. One is this and the other one is this. Let us find out how we can work these relations to our advantage. Thus, we can write this relation as LOM equals 180 degrees minus R1 plus R2, and we have already obtained LOM is equals 180 degrees minus A. So what can we write? We can write from equations 2 and 3 that LOM is equal to this and LOM is also equal to this. And we had previously obtained equation 1 as I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. Now let us see how we proceed further. Since LOM is represented by this as well as this, we can equate equations 2 and 3. So once we equate equations 2 and 3, we come up with 180 minus A, which is equal to 180 minus R1 plus R2, because both of them are equal to angle LOM. So since 180 is common on both sides, we can cancel it out, and we can cancel out the minus as well. So we are left with angle A, which is equal to R1 plus R2. Now, if you observe equation 1, you will find that R1 plus R2 is a term that is present in equation 1 as well. Thus, if we compare equations 1 and equations 4 and take the information that we have, we are getting I1 plus I2 is equals A plus delta. How are we getting this? Because equation 4 tells us that R1 plus R2 is equal to A. So if we replace this value over here and we change the side, then we get delta plus A, that is this, equals I1 plus I2. So we are writing it over here. Now, when we are considering this entire scenario, we have to consider minimum deviation. That is, this experiment is usually found out in the case of a spectrometer. In a spectrometer, a prism is used, and it is used to find out what deviation this ray of light is undergoing. So, in case of a spectrometer, different angles of incidences are considered, and it will be observed that at one particular angle of incidence, the angle of deviation that we are getting is the least or the minimum. At minimum deviation, that is, when the deviation is minimum or when delta is least, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of emergence. Under such a condition, this ray becomes parallel to the base of the prism. So that condition is for minimum deviation, which is found out experimentally with the help of a spectrometer. So for minimum deviation, we are considering I1 is equal to I2, and we say that it is equal to I. We call this value I. Similarly, R1 will be equal to R2, and we call this value R. So if I1 is equal to I2 equals I, how can we write this relation? We can write this relation as 2I equals A plus delta. So we can easily obtain delta as 2I minus A. So from this mathematical derivation, we learned how we can find out the value of delta, that is the angle of deviation, if we are given the angle of incidence and the angle of prism. And this delta is the value of the angle of minimum deviation.